Emerging technologies could help treat Parkinson's disease, schizophrenia, depression, and other psychiatric and neurological diseases. These neurotechnologies could one day go beyond reading information from the brain, to instead giving information to it, potentially shaping our thoughts and behaviors. Without guidelines in place for its use, experts warn the technology poses serious ethical risks.
So neurotechnology is any technology that allows us to interface with the nervous system. What this technology demonstrates is our possibility of overcoming severe neurological disorders and injuries. And using this technology, we've essentially been able to bypass a spinal cord injury and been able to give some sort of functional independence back to somebody who had been chronically paralyzed for many, many years. The applications that we are focusing on are purely medical.
But some companies are now marketing non-medical uses of neurotechnology that can read neural activity and connect with remote devices. And experts are raising flags.
This is an extreme invasion of privacy and of our free will. We're talking about the ultimate privacy, which is privacy of your thoughts, your mental privacy. Let me tell you what we're doing with animals. We can go in with a laser and we can essentially read his mind. We know what he's watching from reading the activity of the neuron. And then comes the next step in which we go in with a second laser and we turn on these neurons in the visual cortex of the mouse. And the mouse thinks that he sees what we're putting in. In other words, we're putting in an artificial image and the mouse behaves as if he's seen this artificial hallucination. We can do this with mice today. This will be possible to do with humans in the future. This reading and writing of information to the brain is going to enable us to decode mental processes and manipulate them.
Before this technology can be used medically or commercially, experts are urging industry leaders and governments to adopt a code of ethics. This technology has a promising future, but when it comes to protecting mental privacy and free will,
I don't think we should wait anymore, because if we do, what will happen is the same thing that happened with social media, that by the time you want to regulate it, it's too late.